Hey, hey, what's up? What's up? Trying to get y'all set up, man. Trying to get myself set up. I got my raggedy tripod holding up my camera, and I don't know how this is going to be. Can y'all hear me good? Let me know if y'all can hear me good real quick, because I'm finna rig some stuff up. Let me know if y'all can hear me real good, because I'm about to rig this stuff up for real, for real. Hold on, I'm just pinning this up like this, and I'm just rigging up some stuff. Can y'all hear me? Yep. Yes. What's going on? I'm going to try to do this real quick, y'all, okay? Because I just want to show y'all something real quick. This is just a cooking tip video, so I'm not going to be long, or whatever the case may be. And I need to cut my AC on, because it's hot. Hold on, y'all. All right, so I hope y'all got enough light. Is there enough light in here? Anyway, let me get some gloves. I'm gonna show y'all something real quick. This is just a cooking tip video, live. Just a cooking tip, that's it. I'm not gonna be cooking nothing on here, but I am gonna cook something today. And I wanted to do a video, but I don't have enough time to do a video. So I wanted to show y'all this little tip real quick that I'm doing on this here whole chicken. All right, so we got some people here, man, and I wear glasses, y'all. Look, I'm looking this way because the screen, the computer screen is here, and I can see your comments over here, but my camera is set up right here, and I'm kind of crooked on this here tripod. You understand where I'm coming from? But anyway, I'm going to try to read y'all names out real quick just to see who was in here, whatever the case may be. Paul Torsa, hey, how you doing? Kevin, what's up, Kevin? Mary, hey, Mary, how you doing? Tracy, what's going on, Tracy? Miss Bullock, how you doing? Cooking at Pam's Place. Hey, what up, girl? What's going on with you? What's going on with you? If y'all don't know who Cooking with Pam's Place is, y'all go over there and check her out. Screenshot right now so you can go back and check out some of her YouTube cooking over there, her channel. She's a beast when it comes to in the kitchen. Samuel, what's up? X Tina Grubbs is in the building. If y'all don't know who X Tina Grubbs is, she's a cool down to earth mukbanger. Y'all please go over there, man, and check out X Tina Grubbs. That's my homegirl, man. I like everything that my sister over there is doing. Y'all please screenshot right now X Tina Grubbs and go over there and check out her channel once this live is over with. X Tina Grubbs, I love you, girl. How you doing? James Reed, what's going on, James Reed? Jacqueline, hey, Jacqueline. Anita's in the building. Okay, y'all, look, check this out. I gotta hurry up, because people got to eat. This is the tip that I want to show you guys, right? So I'm doing a whole chicken, okay? A whole chicken. And I want to show you some of the grossness that took place dealing with this whole chicken. Some grossness. And I tried my best to try to figure some things out. Now, I don't know if you can see this because of the whiteness in it. Whatever, you probably can't see it. It's just some gross scraps or whatever like that. But anyway, you probably don't want to see it, whatever the case may be. I'm hoping you can see this chicken. Let me get over here and see if you can see this chicken. Can you see the bird? Can you see the bird? Can y'all see the ugly bird? That's the ugly bird. All right, now, I took a whole bird, man. Of course, I washed the bird and all this other kind of stuff. All right, let me tell you what I did to this here bird, because I got to put this bird on the grill real quick. I got to hurry up and put it on the grill. But I want to show you guys a nice little tip, and I don't have my seasoning bag. Let me grab that seasoning bag. But while I'm grabbing that seasoning bag, y'all speak to my turkey. Say hello to my chicken right quick. I'll be right back. I'm coming, y'all. I know y'all can still hear me. I hope y'all can still hear me, but hold on. All right, let me see. Grabbing my seasoning bag. Cool. Now, let me just show y'all something real quick. But before I do this, look back up here. Look back at me, y'all. I'm sorry. I got y'all going all over the place. It's just a cooking tip live. That's all. No cooking intended. Now, those of y'all know, I like my seasoning bag. Go get you one. You understand what I'm saying? If you don't have a seasoning bag and you want a seasoning bag, all you got to do is just let me know. Comment below. I want a bag. And I can give you all the seasonings that I have inside this bag, including one of these bags that look just like this. Not the exact bag, but one of the bags that look just like this with all the seasonings that I use. You could definitely purchase this bag from me. You understand what I'm saying? For the low, low price, this is a one-time only special. I'm not going to do this. Today is the only time that I'm going to do this special for this seasoning bag. For one-time price, all right? You can get this here for $1099.99. That's $1,099.00. Today only. That's the special. All right. Yeah, I know y'all like this mofo that bumped his daggone head. Today only you can purchase this bag. Matter of fact, I'm going to cut y'all a deal. I want to save you $100 for $1,000 even. $1,000 even, you can get a spice bag, a Ray Max Kitchen and Grill spice bag. You understand what I'm saying? With all the seasonings that I use for one time only. And that's today. No other day. Just today. You can get this spice bag for $1,000. That's right. You heard it. I'm not joking with you guys. $1,000. Y'all look here. I'm just, y'all look. Somebody got to laugh somewhere. Somebody got to laugh. Somebody said, I want a bag. Come on, man. Y'all better be laughing at that $1,000. Because if any fool out here try to sell y'all a spice bag for $1,000, something wrong with that individual. And something got to be wrong with you if you spend $1,000 on a spice bag. Come on, y'all. That'll be a good little business. But $1,000, Lord have mercy. Ooh, paprika. What my? Okay. Where is my parsley? I went to the store today, man, and you mean to tell me I didn't get that parsley? All right, so let me go get one more flavors. Hold on. All right, so we ready. I got all the spices that I need. All right, so like I said, if y'all really do, man, all jokes aside, no jokes whatsoever. If y'all really want one of these spice bags, man, with all the seasonings that I do have in here, man, you know what I'm saying? And I know I said $1,000 or whatever the case may be for the spice bag, and you can get all the seasonings. Okay, that was a joke. But for real, if you really do want one of these, man, you know what I'm saying, with everything that I do cook with for $995 plus 0 cents, you can have one of these, okay? Just cash at me your money. But here's the thing, though. If you don't receive your bag, whatever you do, don't call, don't email, don't text, nothing. Just wait for about 2 years, and I guarantee you that your bag will, I can't guarantee that, but your bag will be sent sometime of another. But just seeing $995.00, you can get one of these spice bags with everything that I cook with inside the bag for $995. And like I said, go ahead and cash app me now. The cash app is $YouFool. Why you spend all your money on some foolishness? And send that. And I can't guarantee you that you'll receive the bag. But anyway, y'all, come on. Look, this is what we're doing. All right, all the jokes aside. All right, so this is what we got. I got this chicken. I washed the chicken down. So I'm cooking some ribs and a whole chicken on the grill or whatever. But this is what I did with the chicken, y'all. All right. So I cut the chicken down. All right. It's a whole bird. It was a whole bird. But what I ended up doing is I trimmed this bird up the best way that I possibly could. I cut the tail off the bird. Okay. I cut the butt off. You know what I'm saying? The booty. I cut the booty off the bird. All right. And then I trimmed up some of the fat. And as you can see, we still got some fat right here. All you got to do is just see that. That's like gross. Trim up some of that fat, get some of that fat off of it. You know what I'm saying? And like I said, I'm cooking this on the grill. So some of this fat will render down. Now, what I did with the legs, I went and I just took a knife and I just lollipopped them. You know what I'm saying? Took a knife, lollipopped them, and it was easy to come off or whatever the case may be. Because at times when you do cook a whole chicken, a whole bird on the grill or whatever like that, I just don't like these legs, man, with all the extra little stuff on it or whatever. You know what I'm saying? I'm just going to take pieces of aluminum foil during the cooking process and just throw aluminum foil on these here nubs. You know what I'm saying? Y'all know what a nub is. Throw some aluminum foil on that nub and just keep it moving. All right, Mr. Bass, thank you for that liberal giving. Giving it shall be given unto you. Good measures pressed down, shaking together, runneth over. And I pray that if you want chickens with an S on it, that God will bless you with more chicken than you could ever have in your freezer. Thank you so much for your liberal giving. I really do appreciate it. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, and thank you. Now, once I did take the skin off the legs, and I pretty much put them into a lollipop style, trimmed the tail, trimmed off some of the fat, and I cut back some of the skin, and I ended up doing the same thing over here with the neck part. So a lot of times when you do buy turkey or chicken from the grocery store, you still got that protruding neck, and this is the neck, you know what I'm saying? All you got to do is just get you a sharp knife. If you have a sharp knife, just go ahead and cut it, pop it, pull it, and that's a wrap. You know what I'm saying? That's one thing. Now, and then I trimmed away some of the skin that was on the neck part, and as you can see here, that excess, see that? That's excess fat. You don't want that. You just want to go ahead and just trim it off if you want. You know what I'm saying? Trim it off. Trim it off. Trim it off. And do me a favor while you at it. Get that skin. Pull it. See that fat? Get that out of there. You don't want that. You know what I'm saying? This is just a cooking tip live video, what I'm showing y'all right now. You know what I'm saying? And if you guys haven't seen that last video that I did post, with that chicken tenders with the chili Alfredo, please check that out, man. You know what I'm saying? And a couple of people, man, did that recipe and they posted their pictures on Instagram, and I put it in my stories. I thought that was kind of cool, you know what I'm saying? And they really enjoyed it. Like I said, that's a new recipe, man. And I was like searching to see if anybody did something like that on YouTube or anywhere else. And I haven't found nobody else that do something like that. So I kind of thought it was a cool video. But anyway, so with all that being done right there, and if you can look at these titties, you know what I'm saying? These titties kind of fat. And sometimes, man, I don't like the big titties. But, well, anyway, y'all know the big breasts, you know what I'm saying? But we're going to make it do what it do. So now this is still a whole bird. This is still a whole bird. Now, a lot of times when you do buy a whole chicken from the grocery store and you prep it up and you try to put it in the oven, you try to put it in the grill or whatever the case may be, the hardest thing to season inside of a whole bird is the inside, right? I pretty much want to show you a good way how you can still cook a whole bird, you know what I'm saying, and have the whole season, you can still season up the inside pretty good. Now, one thing that I was going to do with these legs so that they can stay pinned up just like this, let me show you, just like this, I was going to take some bread ties, yes y'all, some bread ties, you know what I'm saying, and these are my bread ties, right? If you can see them, these are just basic bread ties. Now I'm not going to do this with these ties because I think this is like plastic on these ties or whatever like that, so I would have to strip this stuff down. That's no problem, but I'm just going to throw this on the grill as is or whatever, but I'm just going to show you this. This is something that you could definitely do in the future. Why? Because this is a cooking tip live video. So I took two of the ties and I twisted them together at one end. Okay. Now this is, if you wanted to try this, all you have to do was take it. All you have to do is just take your legs just like this. You know what I'm saying? These some skinny legs. They look about like my legs. I ain't gonna lie to you though. They really look like my legs for real. But you take your legs, cross them, and then you'll take your ties. All you gotta do is just put your tie right down there in the center between the legs, twist them, and bam, there you go. You see that? You see that? And if you wanted to, you could take another tie, right? And then you get, since you went down that way, all you got to do is just come across so that, and just twist, you know what I'm saying? But if you do this tip, strip the plastic or whatever the case may be, man, and where you could just have your wire showing, and then from there, you could just bend the wires on your ties, and bam, voila, there you go. Legs is intact. If you can see, the leg is intact. It's not going nowhere. Boom, 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 boom. Smack the booty. Boom, boom, boom. All the other good stuff. The legs ain't going nowhere. But it still look presentable. You feel me? Or you could just take you some butcher's twine if you got money to go out there and buy butcher's twine or whatever like that. Hey, we buy bread all the time and I keep these ties. You understand? So I'm just going to take these ties off right now. Okay. I'm going to take these off and I'm going to show you how I season the inside of the meat. But I'm going to show you first how I prepped the inside of this chicken so I can season it up pretty good. Now, on the inside of this bird, what I did, you see this? This is the breastplate of the bird. All right. So I got me a sharp little knife. You know what I'm saying? Sharp little fillet knife. And on that, with the sharp fillet knife, all I had to do was just carve real close to the bone. Somebody's calling me. Hold on. I think they'll be all right. So all I had to do was just carve on the inside of the bone, carve the meat real close to the bone, and basically, man, just pop, snaps out, okay? Now, let me show you the easy part of seasoning on the inside of your bird. If you can see, all that is exposed now. All of this is exposed. All you have to do now is just pretty much take whatever favorite seasonings that you do have after you season the outside of the meat or whatever the case may be. And let's get to that point right now. Let me show you. So I want to season the back part of this bird first, okay? And a lot of times people, I have a tough time with this word, y'all, because I'm countrified or whatever the case may be. Spatchcock their chicken. What that means is they'll cut the whole spinal backbone out from here to here, and they did split the bird in half. But one thing I hate about that, though, is that when you do spatchcock your chicken, you know what I'm saying, and your bird is laying open, everything is loose. You feel me? Now, the way that I like doing it versus spatchcocking the chicken is I'll just either take me a sharp knife and just go straight down the backbone. You know what I'm saying? So that when I do split the chicken in half, everything is still intact. You know what I'm saying? So when I cook it on the stove or when I cook it on the grill or cooking in the oven, none of this is flopping all over the place. You see what I'm saying? None of this is flopping. It's still attached. But since spatchcocking is the new thing right now and a lot of people is doing it, so everybody want to do it. So there you go. If you like spatchcocking your chicken, hey, spatchcock your chicken. I don't give a what you do, spatchcock it. But for people out there who just want to do something different, definitely try that. Now, if you can see right here, this is the whole thigh. The whole thigh is still attached, okay? Both thighs. The breast and the wing part is still attached, all right? So what I'm gonna do now is just season this up real quick. All right, so first thing I'm gonna use is some salt. Throw some salt on this. Bam, 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 boom. Let me hurry up, because this is just me showing you a tip on how to pretty much dress up a whole chicken and where you can flavor and season up the whole chicken, but you're going to have powerful flavor inside and out, okay? And we're going to take some black pepper, and I'm heavy-handed when it comes down to these seasonings, y'all. You know what I'm saying? I just can't eat food if it's not properly seasoned. So that's just me. Now, as you can see, I didn't put no binders on this, no mustard, no oil, no none of that. All right. So I just want to go ahead and take some of this here onion powder. Is that right? Yep, onion powder. Sprinkle that onion powder on there. And I got to hurry up because I got to get my grill going. And I was going to do a video, but hey, people say they hungry, man. They got to eat. So I say, well, I'm just going to show them live. You know what I'm saying? That was some paprika right there. I'm sorry. That was what? Cayenne pepper. And the next thing I'm going to add on this right here, I love that Norris. We're going to put a little Norris on top of that. You know what I'm saying? And I think that's one more thing, the Cajun. I want some Cajun on there. I like a little bit of Cajun. Vanessa, you like Cajun, Vanessa? Huh? You like that Cajun seasoning, Vanessa? Tell me something. Tracy, what about you, Tracy? All right, so now I'm going to add some of this here, man, roasted garlic and bell pepper blend. All right, that's from Ross, because y'all know Ross is the boss. All right, y'all know Ross is the boss. You feel me? Ross is the boss. Anyway, bam. Last but not least, for the outside of this here bird, for the outside of this bird, last but not least, this is the last thing that I'm going to put on this outer exterior of the bird, is some of this here chili parsley garlic blend from Ross. Why? Because Ross is the boss. Just put a little bit of that on there, yeah? And then just get her on up on there. See that? See that? Now, I'm going to turn this baby. I'm going to turn this bird. I want to turn this bird. Turn it. Turnover bird. There you go. Now, with the outside, I'm going to do the exact same thing, using the same seasonings for the outside. I'm telling y'all, my bird going to be seasoned. It ain't nothing flat about this bird when it comes to flavor. You understand? Nothing flat about this bird when it comes to flavor. So that was some salt, and I'm going with some black pepper. You feel me? I don't know if y'all like this or nothing like that, but hey, I hope y'all like this, man. You feel me? I swear. Yes. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to hit it again with some of this here onion powder. Boy, this onion powder smells good. I'm trying to tell you, man, the basic things that you can cook with in your kitchen using recipes is onion powder and garlic powder. Can't go wrong with those two. Now, I got some of this here cayenne pepper that we used on the back end, and we're going to use it on the front end as well. And then I'm going to toss in some of this here, like we say, the Norris chicken flavoring on this here bird. On the bird, the bird, 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 the bird, the word, the bird, bird, bird. Now, again, we're going with the roasted garlic from Ross, because Ross is the boss. I don't know about y'all, but I like that Ross, man. And I'm going to hit it again with this here chili parsley garlic mix, and then get it on up on there. Now we're going to do something different from the inside, because the outside is seasoned up. And I wish y'all could smell this, man. God, so mighty. I wish y'all could smell this. Now, the inside of the bird, this is what I'm going to look. Let me get that tie out of there. The inside of the bird, look. See how flat that whole thigh part is right here? Let me turn it around to you. Look, see that? Look, she open. Come on, y'all. Hit her with some salt, Ray. Ooh, Ray, rub her. Told you heavy-handed with that salt, boy. See there? Then we're going to hit her with some pepper. Told y'all ain't nothing. This bird is going to be seasoned. Seasoned how? To the max. There we go, man. And then I want to go ahead, man, and just use some of this here kicking. I ain't going to use nothing else on the inside, because the outer edges is done. But I want to put in some of this here kicking chicken. Finger licking. Kicking chicken, finger licking from Ross. Why? Because Ross is the boss. I just want to hit on some of that right there, boy. Look at that. Look at that. I wish y'all could smell this. Can you smell that smell? Huh? Huh? What? Who? 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 Boy, look at that chicken. That chicken seasoned. Y'all look here. That chicken right there is seasoned. Can you see it? Can y'all see the seasoning on that chicken? Can y'all see it? Let me just bring it up to you. Look. Look. That's the inside of a whole bird right there. That's the inside of a whole bird. Closer. Closer. Now, if you wanted to, which will add more flavor to this, if you wanted to, because I'm not going to do it. If you wanted to, you can go ahead and take some butter. You can season your butter up, soften it up in the microwave, not melt it, but season it up, season your butter up, salt it, melt it in the microwave, soften it up, and you could take butter and put it on in between the skin. All you have to do is just lift the skin and just add the butter right on up in there and up in there. Now, if you wanted to do something else where you wanted to inject it, all you had to do is just take one of your injectors. You know what I'm saying? A meat injector, whatever favorite injection that you like. Walmart still sells some good stuff out there, y'all, that's on the shelf where you don't have to make up your own stuff. You know what I'm saying? And just inject your meat. Hit the breast, Hit the thighs, hit the legs, and it's easy to inject it because here's the key, here's the kicker. Listen to what I'm finna show y'all right now. This is a cooking tip live video. If you wanted to inject your chicken, instead of injecting your chicken on the outside, poking holes into your skin, tell me something right now. I want you guys to answer this question for me. How would you inject this chicken without poking holes in the skin? I'm listening. I'm waiting. How would you inject your chicken without poking holes in this here skin? Who's going to answer that question? Pull the skin back. I see you, Melissa. Who else is next out there? Who else? Come on, y'all. Come on. How would you inject this chicken? While y'all are doing that, I'm going to season up I got to season up my ribs right now. How would you do it? Key Cam and the fam in the building. What up? Inside. Hey. What up? Key Cam and fam is in the building. That's what I'm talking about. That's what you would do. All you have to do is just lift that bird up, take your injector, and bam, 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 bam. I'm using this knife like it might be an injector. Hit it. You can hit it anywhere in there that you want. You know what I'm saying? With that injector, and you will not have to pierce no holes in that skin. That's how you would do it. That's how easy that is right there, man. You know what I'm saying? That's a whole bird. Took the backbone out. That's it. Whole bird. So, this is, let me look back up here. Hold on, y'all. I got to get these ribs done up. So, I just showed y'all a basic cooking tip live, all right? So, this stuff in this can right here is some Charlie Mills barbecue seasoning. I'm gonna share a secret with y'all about this here Charlie Mills. Every time I use this Charlie Mills, it makes me sneeze every time. If I always say this, if you using Charlie Mills seasoning and you don't sneeze, it's not Charlie Mills. I'm sorry. So I'm gonna season up my ribs with this here Charlie Mills. What? There it is. There it is. Charlie Mills is real, baby. Boy, when I tell you she is potent, the seasons up in this here is real, mama. That Charlie Mills is real. Now, another thing that I use, let me hurry up. I use that Charlie Mills. And I'm not putting no binder on these ribs either. No binder is going on these ribs. And I'm using some of this here Mike D's barbecue seasoning. Mike D's is a local barbecue company. Oh man, that thing got me though. And I like Mike D's barbecue seasoning. It's really good. So with the Charlie Mills and the Mike D's combined, oh my God, some good flavor. But that Charlie Mills ain't nothing but the daggone truth. Jesus, nothing but the truth. My last thing that I'm going to use, last but not least, is going to be just some of this here barbecue seasoning. You could definitely use whatever favorite barbecue seasoning you got. But these are all I use on my ribs. So if I do anything different or I want different flavors, I play around with different flavors. If I'm on the go and I want something fast, quick, and in a hurry, I use these three flavors. That's it. No Kansas City barbecue ribs here. Just your basic barbecue ribs. You understand? No Carolina ribs here. Just your basic barbecue ribs. And that's how I like rolling. Keeping everything basic and simple whenever I'm cooking at the house. All right? So I got a lot of stuff to put up real quick. So I'm going to take this glove off. Get my nose together. Y'all had to forgive me. Because that Charlie Mills ain't nothing but the joke, nothing but the truth. It ain't nothing but the truth. So, this is why I wanted to tell y'all, man. Why I wanted to come on here. I wanted to show you how, you know what I'm saying, to basically cut up a whole chicken. Well, not cut up a whole chicken. Prep a whole chicken. And where you can fully, like, season the inside of that bird, because a lot of times we'll hold the bird up and then we'll shake seasonings on the inside of that bird or whatever the case may be. And I'm like this, if you had to, all you had to do is basically trim your bird up the way that you want to trim it and then go inside, man, and cut that breastbone out. And once you cut that breastbone out, and it's easy to cut the breastbone out, and I'm going to do a video with prepping this whole bird. And I'm going to show y'all how I do it from beginning to end. That way you can get a feel, even if you want to do it on the inside of the house, and it takes the cooking time down dramatically. You understand what I'm saying? It really cuts the cooking time down seriously. I'm telling you, man. So I'm going to get this on the grill right now, and I'm going to have this bird done within about a couple of hours, because I got the bird will be done within about an hour and some change. But these ribs, I'm going to let these things slow roll on the grill, and I got to clean the rest of this stuff up. So with these here, I'm going to have me some cornbread, some peas, some corn, and I might toss in some string beans. Now, for a lot of y'all out there, man, who don't want to take the easy route out eating some food, y'all better stop acting like, boy, y'all, look here. I'm 100% when it comes down to this cooking thing. I ain't got time to be spending a whole lot. I don't have a lot of time to be spending in this kitchen. So I'm pulling out canned goods, and I'm going to eat, season them canned goods, and I'm going to eat like a king. Do you understand? So a lot of times, man, if you want to cook good food, go in there and cook good food. You don't have to go and use fresh string beans and all this other kind of stuff. Man, come on, y'all. You know what I mean? Now, if you're cooking for a party or you're cooking for a group of people, then I can understand what you're doing. But I'm not cooking for a party or a group of people. I'm cooking for me and my wife. So there you go. But anyway, I want to have some left over for tomorrow as well. And if I can freeze some of this stuff, I'm going to freeze some of it so I can pull it out and eat it and nibble on it whenever the time comes. So I want y'all to do this. Check out the whole chicken and how it is seasoned on the inside and out. So that means to me that every bite is going to be flavored down. You understand what I'm saying? Get in the kitchen and do me a favor, y'all. Do me, look up. God, I'm talking to y'all, and y'all steady looking at the daggone chicken, man. You got to look at me when I'm talking to you. That's what's wrong with y'all. Y'all always want to look up. See, you do, look up. Please look up. Okay. Now, I'm finna go. Thank you so much for checking out this here video. I really do appreciate it. And whatever y'all do today, man, I always say this. Enjoy life. You know what I'm saying? Enjoy life. And before I close this video out, I want y'all to do me a favor, man. Always be a help meet for somebody. You know what I'm saying? Help some type of elderly person if you could, you know what I mean? And other than that, man, love and not hate. Love somebody and hate nobody. If nobody ever told you that they loved you on today, let me still be the first one to say it to you. I love you. And there is truly nothing in this whole wide world that you could do about it. So let's just do these things, man. Let's get rid of hatred. Let's get rid of envy. Let's get rid of jealousy. And let's just move forward. If you're a YouTuber and you need some help one way or another of growing your channel or whatever the case may be, come on, man, let's just help one another. We need to hit that ladder and go up, and let's not try to take our feet and push the next person down who's trying to climb that ladder. So if we can help one another, let's just do it. I love y'all, man. Hey, I'm out of here. Peace. Welcome to Ray Mac's Kitchen and Grill. Love and not hate. Love.